Good morning. Happy Easter. If you know this, please join together in this Easter hymn. Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name. Spread the good news o'er all the earth. Jesus has died and has risen. Alleluia, alleluia. Give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Give praise to his name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of you. Sisters and brothers, as we come together to celebrate these Easter mysteries, we call to mind our sins, entrust us to the loving goodness of our God who forgives us, and we ask the Lord to give us a share in his resurrection in this life and in the world to come.
You died for our sake and brought an end to death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you reconcile sinners to the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Prince of Life who died and reigns immortal. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. In this octave of Easter, we pray with angels and saints. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who give constant increase to your church by new offspring, grant that your servants may hold fast in their lives to the sacrament they have received in faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to my words. You who are children of Israel, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad and my tongue has exalted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with the joy in your presence.' My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and that his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him, that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne. He foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he poured forth the promise of the Holy Spirit that he received from the Father, as you both see and hear. The word of the Lord. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup, you it is who hold fast my lot. Keep me safe, O God, for you are my hope. I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Keep me safe, O God, for you are my hope. Therefore my heart is glad, my soul rejoices, my body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. Keep me safe, O God, for you are my hope. You will show me the path of life, fullness of joys in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever. Keep me safe, O God, for you are my hope. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce the news to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." While they were going, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priests all that had happened. The chief priests assembled with the elders and took counsel. Then they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers, telling them, "You are to say, 'His disciples came by night and stole him while we were asleep.' And if this gets to the ears of the governor, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble." The soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has circulated among the Jews to the present day. The Gospel of the Lord.
I think it's a truism to say that for the most part we enjoy new beginnings, because with new beginnings come new possibilities, new hopes, new dreams. When I celebrate the sacrament of reconciliation or confession, especially with children but also with adults, I always talk in terms that the forgiveness they experience is a new beginning, a new relationship with the Lord. They're like babies again. They're like, "Oh yeah, I could see that." But it's the same for us as adults. When we experience that forgiveness, that mercy of God, we are new. We are recreated. We are in the image then of what God originally intended us to be. That brings all sorts of hope, at least to me, and an excitement about the possibilities that come with that. We are at a point in our celebration of Easter, in the Easter season, of new possibilities, and the readings reflect that today, both the first reading from the second chapter of the Acts of the Apostles and the gospel passage today from the end of St. Matthew's gospel. They both talk about beginnings. Just an overview, if you come to daily Mass or you participate digitally at Mass or you read the readings every day, you'll know that throughout the Easter season, we'll read from the first reading, will come from the Acts of the Apostles. And that is the story of the development of Christianity, from its humble beginnings in Jerusalem to being spread to the ends of the earth. And we hear today in the second chapter, in the third line, that word Jerusalem. Peter and the other disciples, the other apostles, are proclaiming the good news. They are apostles sharing the good news, and it starts in Jerusalem. And from there, they go out. They go out to the ends of the earth because they are so moved by their experience of the resurrected Christ, they cannot hold back. They go out into the world, and at the end of the Acts of the Apostles, we'll hear that some are in Rome. And Rome is considered the ends of the earth because from there, you know, the empire spreads out. So just listen for that. From humble beginnings, the Spirit touches our church and brings the good news to the ends of the earth. We hear the beginning of the good news in today's gospel, too, immediately after the resurrection. We hear about Mary Magdalene and the other Mary who went quickly away from the tomb when they witnessed that it was empty, when they heard the message from the angel, when they were directed to go and say and share that good news with the apostles. The humble beginnings of the church comes from Mary Magdalene. I love that the early church fathers and Pope Francis affirmed this. They call Mary the apostle of the apostles. She is the first one to share the good news to those who share the good news to the ends of the earth. At the end of the story, we hear about a concocted story to kind of explain what happened, but it never really kind of takes root to undermine the story of the resurrection of Christ. So here again, we hear about humble beginnings of our Christian faith. In today's reading, the two Marys run to announce the good news. I'm struck by that. And do you remember the gospel from yesterday morning if you came to church for Easter Sunday? James and John, when they heard that good news and they were in the upper room, what did they do? They ran. They ran. In fact, John says, I think it must be some self-boasting that he's doing, that the beloved disciple outran Peter and got to the tomb first. But they ran. They remind us that our experience of the faith has to be all in. It's not just a slow walk or, you know, walking at a good clip. It's a run. You have to invest yourself to run. You have to exert yourself. That's what God wants us to do regarding our faith. He wants us to be all in, and Mary, the other Mary, and John and Peter all show us that. So today, as we recall the humble beginnings of our faith, may we also be grateful for the deep roots that our faith has in dedicated people like the apostles, like Mary Magdalene and the other Mary. Let us ask God to help us to be all in relative to our faith, to run towards that end, which is eternal life, and share that good news with all. We stand together and pray for each other as we offer these petitions to the Father.
For the Church, may the Holy Spirit continue to guide and protect her in this Easter season and magnify her light of truth and goodness in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may the Lord bless them with a fearless vision to act for the true common good of those they govern. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all whose struggles with addiction have caused separation from their families, may they, through the mercy of God, be reconciled with their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are welcomed into the church at this Easter vigil, May they continue to grow in the gifts and fruits of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of our deceased family members, may they soon share in the joy of the resurrected Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Dale Smith, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for our sisters and brothers who live just to the south of us in Bradenton and Palmetto, who face kind of an incredible environmental disaster, that the Lord will keep them safe, that the Lord will keep them healthy. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, we offer these prayers in faith. Help us in our need, and with hearts filled with joy because of the resurrected Christ, may we, like the apostles, share that good news with others. We ask this in the name of Jesus, risen Lord and Messiah, and in union with your Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters, pray, brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Accept graciously, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your peoples, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to praise you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, O holy, O holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gregory, our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious, and your faithful everywhere. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. In faith, in joy, we pray to God our Father in the words our resurrected Savior Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the grace of this Paschal sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, O Lord, and make those you have set on the way of eternal salvation worthy of your gifts, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.